President Marcos has finalized his first foreign trips as the country's leader. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles confirms Marcos will visit Indonesia on September 4 to 6. He will then travel to Singapore on September 6 to 7. Cruz Angeles adds the Philippine leader will also visit the U.S., but the trip's details are still being worked out. Marcos is also expected to participate in the United Nations General Assembly in New York next month. Philippine tax officials seek the help of shopping apps to check on online sellers for possible tax violations. Bureau of Internal Revenue Commissioner Lilia Guillermo says the agency will hold a summit with Shopee and Lazada next month to discuss the possible partnership. Guillermo notes the shopping platforms are currently reluctant in giving the BIR data, citing privacy. She also asserts the Bureau will begin to monitor online sellers again in the coming weeks, but she clarifies it's only going after big-time sellers. Senator Rafi Tulfo earlier flagged the BIR for supposedly running after small social media influencers and sellers rather than big-time smugglers. Philippine Socioeconomic Planning Chief Arsenio Balisacan highlights the crucial role of the private sector in the country's growth efforts. Balisacan said the private sector can help bring in investments that will lead to high-quality job creation. Balisacan also gives his assurance the government will be ready to implement the needed economic reforms.
The private sector can count on MEDA to push and shepherd necessary reforms and to provide strong guidance and economic policies that aim to promote sustained and inclusive economic growth in line. The government is mindful of the significant role the private sector plays in increasing productivity, driving innovation, creating jobs and market opportunities, and addressing the long-standing and emerging issues of our country.
Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla also bears their role in sustaining the country's growth momentum.
They've done 225, we've done 175. We have no choice. We have to respond to the Fed, but we don't have to match every point that they do because their inflation is higher. We will exit. As the economy recovers, we will gradually lift the rates. 25, 25, 25, 25. And then we will let the securities that we bought mature gradually.
Philippine officials expect a significant drop in poverty incidence next year. The National Economic and Development Authority says this can be fulfilled if growth recovery efforts are sustained. NEDA Undersecretary Rosemary De Leon adds the economy should be further reopened to boost the recovery.
Tapos, kailangan din na i-ensure natin yung ating health system capacity. Tapos yun nga, as a matter of policy, patuloy dapat sa pagbubukas. Kaya we thank the DepEd, especially si VP and Education Secretary, na talaga pong inano niya na ibalik na natin yung face-to-face classes. So pangalawa po na intervention natin is dagdagan pa yung investments on human capital, no? Una, para magkaroon ng capabilities nga para makapag maging productive ang bawat isa at maging agile po. So ibig sabihin, kahit anumang crisis, huwag naman na sana, makaya natin.
The number of poor Filipinos in 2021 rose to nearly 20 million. The government hopes to lift up to 9 million Filipinos out of poverty by the end of President Marcos's term.